ho, 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 Merry Crit. Oh, I'm recording. Right. Aim Trainer. All right, so last time we destroyed the reaction test with a score of 10 milliseconds, which meant we got to the 100th percentile. So let's see if we can do that for the Aim Trainer. Future Jake here. Stick around to the end if you want to see how fast you can make this, if you cheat just a little. But before we start, let's see what kind of score I can get. It is the human benchmark, after all. 433 milliseconds? That's not bad, I guess, right? What'd you guys get? I'm starting to feel my age a bit here. Well, screw that. If I code something to beat it, it's the same thing as me beating it, right? Totally. Let's go with that. Alright, so what's the plan of action for this? Just like when we beat the reaction test, we'll need to determine when an area of the screen has a specific color in it, and then get the color's coordinates to know where to click. So basically, we find the color, and we click the color. Seems pretty easy. So let's do it. All right, let's run it. Wow, that is nearly as slow as when I did it. All right, so our current implementation loops over all of the pixels in the area to try and see if one of them matches the color we're looking for. That sounds slow. So how can we fix this? Any ideas, Sammy? Great suggestion. So, we make the area smaller. Perfect. But how does that work? We need to look at the play area, so we need to look at all the pixels, right? Wrong. Well, not completely wrong. What we can do is downscale the image by some factor. I chose 8. This means that an 8x8 grid of pixels will become a single pixel. Basically, this means that we are effectively reducing the total number of pixels we need to search over by a factor of 8. So, let's run it. Oh yeah, that's faster. 125 milliseconds. Now that's way better. Our average is based on the last 5 games, so let's run this a few more times to get the percentile. Surely it's going to be 100% though. Oh my god, we're so close. 99.9. So, I can't think of any way to get this faster. Even closing OBS, I still only got 99.9%. I can either quit at 99% and fail my 100 percentile challenge for getting 100% on all these, but I don't want to be a quitter. So, back to the drawing board. On my way to the drawing board, I had a bit of an epiphany. The highest percentile I can get is 99.9% with Python. So what if I try a more performant language? So I decided to brush off some C++ skills. Let's just say it's a bit faster. I'm also doing the same thing. I'm capturing the screen, checking for a color, and clicking the color. But I may have overstated my accomplishment here a bit. One way to make things a bit easier for me, at least when coding, was to make the color stand out a little bit more. Yeah, I just changed the CSS and made the target red. Is this cheating? Well, I mean, I'm using a program to beat the game, so I'm gonna go with no. But if you wanna see cheating, stick around to the end, because oh boy, you sure can cheat on this one. So let's run our new C++ program with our pristine red circle. Blue's overrated anyways. Damn, 38 milliseconds. Now that has to be 100 percentile. Let's confirm by running it a few more times to get the average down. We did it. Yes. Okay, so 38 milliseconds is amazing, but how low can we get it if we cheat a little? So one thing that I figured out is that we can guarantee the location of a target. How, you might ask? Well, for this game, it wants to determine a random X and Y coordinate. It does this by calling math.random, which is a JavaScript-based function that returns a value between 0 and 1. This is really common for programmers to do if they want to make a random number. In this case, it's great because you can then multiply the width of the play area by the random value, and then do the same for the height, and then that gives you a random X and Y coordinate. But one fun thing about JavaScript is that you can override functions. This means that if we make it so that math.random always returns, say, 0, then when the game tries to calculate what the X and Y coordinates will be for the target, it will basically just do the width times 0 and the height times 0. So that means that the target will always be in the top left of the play area. So how fast can we click the target if we know where it will be? Let's see. All right, that was so fast I didn't even really see it happen. 15 milliseconds. That's a solid 23 milliseconds faster than if it was moving. Again, this is obviously cheating and breaking the game, but I just kind of wanted to show it to you because I think it's kind of fun. So we have once again destroyed a game in the human benchmark using code. I hope you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more. I will be taking a 2-week vacation to spend some time with family and friends, but I'll be back in 2 weeks, likely exhausted from the holidays, but with more content for you all. But remember, I'm Jake, you're awesome, and this has been Beating the Aim Trainer. Cheers, and Merry Christmas.